Hey everyone, Havoc here, coming to you with another tank review. Today we're going to be doing the T-34-3, the Chinese Tier 8 medium premium tank. It's a preferential matchmaking tank, so it only sees up to Tier 9, much like the Type 59. Clearly the Type 59 is the king of Chinese medium premium tanks, but this is a decent second place. One of the big reasons I'm doing this tank review is because this tank just received a substantial buff on console. It had already received a huge buff on PC, and the PC buff is much better than the one on console, but the buff we did get, being added 2 degrees of gun depression, is a big deal, only because honestly I feel like the tank was almost unplayable before without with the 3 degrees of gun depression. Now with 5 degrees of gun depression, it's actually become a playable tank. You can do pretty well in it, and sometimes you can do really well in it. I also have experience with the Chinese medium line. I have the 121, which has 3 degrees of gun depression. Now that's also been buffed to 3.5 degrees. So I'm used to playing tanks with no gun depression. It's really frustrating. I don't recommend any of those tanks for an inexperienced player. The only people that should be playing these tanks are experienced players. You might want to actually have a pretty good heavy tank background, because heavy tanks don't normally have a lot of gun depression. So you got to be able to be used to that, and know where to go on maps, know where not to go, most importantly. I think it's more about where not to go with tanks that have no gun depression than is where to go. But especially maybe with the tanks that have good turrets, this tank is now plays a lot like a T-62A. There's 7 degrees of gun depression on the Type 59, so it's not quite like a Type 59 at all. Although the chassis acts the same and the armor is a little bit similar, I still prefer the Type 59 by far with armor. The gun on the Type 59 is totally different than this gun. The big thing with the T-34-3 is that it has a 122mm cannon, and that's the biggest. That's going to give you the biggest alpha at 390, average alpha. That's the biggest alpha in the game for a Tier 8 medium. No Tier 8 medium hits as hard as this tank does. I feel like it should hit harder. I know the PC buff actually lowers the reload time and gave it some more gun dispersion, and we only got the gun depression. So I kind of see where the PC buff was more viable, or at least why they did it. I still think the tank could use those buffs here on console, but I'm also going to show you some gameplay. Basically, the tank the way it was before the 2 degrees of gun depression buff, and then the way it is now. All my stats have gone way up since the 2 degrees of gun depression. Like I said, the tank has become a playable medium tank, whereas before it was nothing but just pulling out all your hair. It was just raw alpha, but it was just such an awkward and painful tank to play that I stopped playing it, and I pulled all the equipment off it, and I just put it in the back of my garage. It's as you can see, I've purchased the Black Edition, which was only available on Black Friday, but you can buy the regular T-34-3 in the tech tree right now. I don't believe it's an expensive tank. And you might want to consider it. It's 11,000 gold, which is a little bit expensive, a little bit pricey. But you might want to think about it now that it has the gun depression buff, but because you're not going to be able to get the Black Edition. But I got to play it before and didn't like it. I played it for about 40 games and didn't have a lot of success. Occasionally, I had a couple big games just because of the huge amount of damage that you can do with this gun. But it was no way to be consistent with the gun depression. Just, it was such an awkward tank. So, here's the T-34-3. Ever since the buff, I've really, really enjoyed it. I've had some big games. Much more consistency, and the really big games are even bigger than most Tier 8 premium tanks. You can really get into the 4,000, 5,000 damage range in this tank now. Whereas, with maybe like a CDC or some of the other premium tanks, that's a lot harder to do. It's quite easy for this tank just because of the damage potential. I'll say it right now, the best and the worst thing about this tank is still the gun. Even with the gun depression making it more usable and a little bit more versatile, it's still the most troll gun in the game probably I've ever had. I mean, it's right up there with the WZ-120, which is probably even better. Just for a medium to be able to fire this kind of caliber cannon, the aim time and the accuracy issues that come down with it. This gun is only 185 millimeters, or sorry, 175 millimeters of penetration with its AP shell. That's not very good at all. That's pretty bad. You're gonna have a hard time penning bigger tanks in the front, which is where you're gonna need to use the heat. And with this accuracy, I mean, you can see 0.46 accuracy, 3.4 aim time, which is just that's a long time. So firing heat is not great when you have a low accuracy tank like this. So you're gonna want to minimize that by being in a medium range to your opponents. I say medium range. Obviously, being up close helps a lot. But this tank is a support tank, and it is not a brawling style tank, mainly because of the fact that it shoots 4.48 rounds per minute, which is really low. So the DPM on this tank is kind of terrible. I think the alpha should be higher, honestly. For only hitting for 390 when you fire that rarely, I mean, basically a CDC hits for 240 and they almost shoot two shells for one of yours. So this rate of fire, this DPM is terrible. If you're up against an opponent and you're up close and personal, and they're pretty much going to pen you in the hull every time they shoot you. So if they're just DPMing you, your DPM is terrible. You'll hit them once really hard and then you'll be dead. So you don't want to get in any close to close engagements. Maybe if you were side hugging, that's your only choice, side or face hugging, using your turret armor. Speaking of turret armor, let's go take a look at that. This is the only armor you'll get on the tank, is your turret armor. It's pretty good. As you can see, all the most heavily armored part of the turret is in the front. It's a little bit flat though. That's not usually a good sign. I mean, it's kind of flat armor. So APCR and heat are definitely going through your turret face for anything that's firing at you from like tier 8, and certainly most tier 9 tanks are going through your turret, especially if they're using premium ammo. And you can see a little bit on the sides here, but the turret is it's got some armor on it. You will get some bounces, especially if you're facing regular rounds, especially if you're facing lower tier opponents. But as far as the hull goes, pretty rare that you're going to get a bounce, maybe just extreme angles or whatever. So you want to get hull down, which is a lot easier now that you have 5 degrees of gun depression. And you're going to need some time to aim your shots. You really need to aim really hard with this tank. I definitely recommend consumables. Improved combat rations is pretty much a must with this tank. It has 12% chance of fire in the engine, although I do find you start on fire kind of a good amount, which is disappointing and sucks, but I just don't see running this tank without premium consumable, because it's so important that this gun handling is good. It's the most important thing about the tank. Like I said, the best and worst thing about the tank is the gun. And you have to be on the right side of that gun, or else you're gonna have a terrible game. I do premium consumable. I do vents with vert stabilizer and rammer. I mean, rammer, obviously your reload time is already atrocious. Vert stabilizer, the gun handling is terrible. You need all the help you can get, and that's why I went with vents. I'm not even worried about optics or anything like that, because it's all about this gun. Crew skills. As you can see, like, Brothers in Arms is huge again, because everything you can do to improve crew training and maybe get better gun handling skills, better a little slightly better accuracy and better dispersion, you need to do that. Sixth Sense goes with any tank pretty much. I do Mentor because I'm trying to make this into a master Chinese crew. It's my first Chinese crew on this account, and I plan on putting a lot of skills on this crew, so I'm using Mentor to try and get as many skills as possible. And then I would go right into Snapshot, followed by Smooth Ride. Those are the next two skills I think you'd have to have for this tank, because the gun is just, it's that bad. And if you can get the gun working well, you can have big games, but it's all about the gun, first and foremost. So that's the way I would do it. Sixth Sense, Brothers in Arms, and then both first Snapshot and then Smooth Ride. I mean, after that, you can start working on repairs, or maybe maybe your view range stuff. The view range on the tank isn't bad. The camo value on the tank isn't bad. So that's those are good factors to work on later on after you get done with the gun skills. I'd probably want to get some better view range, but if I'm going to do view range, I probably would want to go towards optics. That's how I usually do it, which means I'd have to take vents off so I'd have to be able to be comfortable taking vents off before I even think about going down the view range area. I'd probably do repairs next. So as I said, armor is only in the turret, and the gun is really difficult. And if you can get it working properly, and you stay back, you want to be in a medium support role. You know, there's like heavy tanks that you call like heavy support heavy tanks. They're not frontline heavy tanks. They don't have the armor for that, but they want to be behind the heavy tank to help them in supporting fire. Like an autoloader, like an AMX-50B, is a support heavy. You don't want to be the first thing they see. You don't want your armor, you know, isn't really there. Every shot you take is going to be absorbed. So you want to just kind of show up, and you want the other heavy tanks to be the one bouncing shots and using their armor, and you just want to show up as extra fire support to kill the enemies faster. So I usually hang back in this tank, try and find a place that's hull down and see if I can support. The gun is terrible. I would never use it over long distances, at the edge of your render range. With that being said, as you get your crew skills going, as you use the premium consumable and the vents and everything, when you finally get the gun down to its best form, you can, from medium range, you can still hit shots pretty well. The biggest problem you'll run into at that point is the penetration. It's 175 millimeters of penetration is really weak. I mean, the CDC is 212. The STA 2 now is 212 millimeters of penetration on its AP round. So 175 millimeters of penetration on your standard round is pretty low. You're definitely going to want to be in a position where you can hit sides, rears, or soft tanks. The best tanks in the game for this tank to run into, you want to see like a poor M6 or a T1 Heavy, God forbid. I don't know how they would end up in your games, but M6 would be a good example. The Tigers are great, because the Tigers are not that maneuverable and fast to get away, and they really don't have any armor to speak of, and they have a lot of HP. So this 175 really has no problem penning Tigers. I mean, occasionally you bounce, but trust me, this gun will bounce occasionally on anything. It's definitely a troll gun, but the games where it's working are the games where you're going to have, you know, 4K damage. So, all right, I'm just going to get to some gameplay. I'm going to show you, I'm not even going to go like straight gameplay like I normally do. I'm going to do more of showing you some clips on the tank before the gun depression buff, and then I'll be sure to let you know that the clips that are going to be later are going to be the ones after the gun depression buff. So you'll get a good idea of how the tank performs now that it's got the 5 degrees of gun depression. All right, here we are in some gameplay. We're in highway. This is a pre-buff, so it's 3 degrees of gun depression. The big problem with having no gun depression is basically if you come over to any kind of hill, anything where you have to like go over it and get your barrel down, you're exposing a lot more of your tank than you ever would. 10 degrees of gun depression, which some tanks have, means you're just exposing your gun barrel and that's about it to shoot. Here you're going to see situations where I have to expose a whole lot of tank just to get my gun barrel down enough to fire. You're also going to see the accuracy issues with the tank, but
ready to fire.
You can kind of see my barrel just like bouncing up and down. I'm right on that 3 degrees mark, so the slightest movement of my tank causes the barrel to go up or down. That'd be a really hard shot to hit. I don't know why I even bothered, but I wanted to try and catch the very top side of his turret. So I'm kind of falling back now. In order to use this tank, I think you have to be really, really patient. You're not going to be the frontline tank. That's a bounce right there off the turret. If you are able to maintain like a hull down stature, the front of the turret is pretty good, especially against regular rounds. It's not surprising to get a bounce when you're hull down. Especially in tier 8 games. Tier 9 games, I don't know if I would sit there and expect to get a lot of bounces. So there's another turret bounce. There's two turret bounces. good hit on the T-20. You're really looking for available targets, targets that are not well armored. That's kind of your bread and butter with this tank. Yeah. Still blocking hits, still haven't taken any damage yet. Just trying to... I'm going to use this lip right here and see if I can kind of maintain my hold down status behind this lip. Problem is it's kind of going uphill, which means my barrel is pretty much never going to be down enough to fire. I'm still trying to play with it right here just to get a little bit in. 175mm penetration was not enough to go through the, looks like the gun mantlet of the Tiger, which is probably about right. Maybe if I caught him a little bit more in the cheek, it would have gone in. So now we got a Tiger II coming up. Tiger II is a really difficult engagement for this tank. He's got plenty of pen. He'll probably pen my turret rather easily, especially if he uses premium ammo. There, I finally got a shot in. This place of engagement, it'll show you the gun depression issues. I had to go to heat mainly because the Tiger is basically hauled down with my gun depression. And there I finally get a shot into the Tiger II's lower plate. With regular rounds, if his lower plate's angled at all, it's probably going to bounce. Just the 175mm penetration is not enough for an angled lower plate. I shouldn't auto-lock that one. Probably should have aimed better because he's turned his turret and actually could have hit him side turret and definitely would have got a pen there. But now he's facing me. I do have heat loaded, so I could go through his turret face, and I think you'll see me try to do that and be successful in a minute. Instead, I tried to go for a little cupola shot from being below him. Was unlikely to happen. He tries to advance on me. The good thing with this gun, especially if this player, if the player isn't very familiar with the tank, once you hit him and they see the alpha, and then here I just went through his turret face with heat. So now that he's been hit, you know, probably three times by me, I'm the one who's drained all his health. I've only been penned once. He's backing away because he doesn't like what's happening there. I tracked him, shooting into the tracking wheel. When you're firing heat, that's pretty much going to be a tracking shot. And I didn't do any damage, which really isn't too surprising. And I managed to pen his lower plate with heat there. Switch back to AP rounds. Now that I'm not facing the Tiger II. This is literally one of the best games I was able to put together. I think I have two decent games that I was able to put together with the T-34-3 with the 3 degrees of gun depression. The alpha's great, the DPM's terrible, and the gun depression just made the tank almost unplayable. Here's a tank destroyer, the British tank destroyer, pretty soft target, so I kind of just auto-locked him. That's pretty dangerous to fire on the move like that. It's okay if you have some like safe alternative, like you can just get away, but in that situation, since you fire, there's the accuracy, went right into the ground. I could have aimed in all the way, I probably should have. You really need to aim in all the way with this tank. But you gotta think about the fact that you have quite a long reload, so if you get close to a target and miss, you're probably gonna take several shots before you can hit them back. I'm trying to stay hull down here on this hill. I'm surprised the rest of the team hasn't destroyed me for being here. I guess they must be deep in the city still. Or they must be out of the city. I'm not sure what the red team's doing. I just skipped ahead. The end of that game really isn't exciting. Here on Sand River. Another pre-buff clip. So 3 degrees of gun depression. This is pretty much a terrible place to go with this tank, although I play with almost all my mediums. You're going to see me try and make the gun depression work here. There's only a very small window that I can fire into. Thanks a lot, artillery. But unfortunately for this KV-85, he seems to drive right through that small little window where I'm actually able to get my gun barrel down enough. You'll see several times me having to readjust this game because I can't get my gun barrel down. But you also see a couple good turret bounces, and a couple good pens. Pretty bad to have an SDA up there. That's not good, because he's going to be able to shoot down on my position.
But we have some tanks that are going up north, so he can't exactly just sit there and fire into me. We have a KV-4 and a T-34, so we got some heavy hitters for a Tier 8 match. Oh, our KV-85 friend is back. We put a second shot into him. I mean, he's practically a two-shot for us, so he's actually lucky to be alive, probably. Try to hit the capole on the KV-4. That's a tall order with the accuracy on this tank. I'm gonna bounce the upper plate of the T-34 Black, which is pretty annoying. Although it's been happening to me a lot lately, I guess the T-34 Black. I just assume, much like the T-29, that the upper plate of the T-34 would be rather weak, but apparently not. So I switched to heat to give me a better chance of penning, since I'm hitting him. He is exposed his upper and lower plate right there. With the accuracy issues, I don't know where I'm going to be able to hit him, so I'm just trying to hit him anywhere in the front. That's how I finally get the pen. Gun depression. Hull down T-34. Luckily, he insists on advancing far enough to give me a shot into his upper plate. I don't really understand why he keeps doing that when he's right here. He's obviously hull down. Then he turns his turret, gives me his the side of his turret, so I'm able to knock him out. KV-4 is rushing me here. Bounce. So there's the armor at work. I probably shot him in the wrong spot there. I don't know if it was because he was angled or just the idea of shooting him in the lower plate. Maybe the KV-4's lower plate really isn't the place to shoot him.
Enemies looking right at us.
When he advances next time, I'll find a more suitable location to pen him. Right now, I'm just going to try and do some capola shots, which is working.
Friendly vehicle destroyed.
Now I decide to hit him more in the upper plate areas at that flat bar that I can pen.
We finished him off.
I probably should have tried something like that to start with. But so this is a pretty good game, especially for the pre-buffed T-34-3. Just kind of being patient. Trying to stay hull down and see if I can get the gun depression to work for me. Here it's not going to work as I advance on this hill corner. You're just not going to be able to get your barrel down. So I'm trying to figure out if there's any way to sneak a shot in there, or I'm going to have to advance. I'm kind of waiting for that tank on the north to make a move, and then the T-32 will be distracted. I can move in. Trade shots right there. That's kind of one of the nice things with this gun too, is that you can really, I mean, you can trade shots. You're gonna hit them harder than they hit you most of the time. I even with the 132, I'm pretty sure I have a higher alpha than him. Yeah, the 324s, I mean, the low rolls really frustrate you with this tank, just because, as I said, the typical tier 8 medium would be firing a 90mm and shooting, and alpha would be about 240, and they're going to fire almost twice for every one time you fire. So when you hit for 320, it's pretty annoying, because that's only 80 more than the 90 who's going to fire again. So, I mean, I could have got two pens there on that T-32. Instead of just the one. Here's an M6 side profile. This is the kind of thing right here. Picking on lower tier tanks is what this tank does best, because they're not heavily armored enough, and the 175 pen is pretty viable. Now I'm up against a T-44, which actually is a well-armored tank, comparatively for 175, but I get his full side, so I'm not really worried about it. You really want to be shooting sides and backs with this tank. That's the big thing, is getting to people's sides. Don't want to try and go through their front armor, and if you do, you're probably going to want to use heat, or you're really going to have to get into their lower plate straight on. But that's the end of the pre-buff videos. So I'm gonna head now to the after buff videos, and you'll notice that there's a lot more freedom with the tank and how what you can do. But as you can see, when you get the gun going and you're getting pens, you can do a lot of damage for a tier 8 medium.
Alright, here we're getting into the post-buff video, so 5 degrees of gun depression. The first thing I will say about this clip is, starting here on Prokhorovka, at the E6 square, a place that I like to go with mediums to be able to support the hill. This is not a position I would have liked to have tried to do with the 3 degrees of gun depression and the pre-buff T-34-3. It really would not have worked. 5 degrees is just barely working, but you're trying to play this hill. I can shoot both sides of the field. I can shoot the 1-2 line, and I can shoot the 9-0 line. 1-2 line more if they're kind of hanging up on the higher side of the 1 line. And then there's also tanks in front of me on the 6 line. So this is a power position. I really like to play this on this map. But without any gun depression, it's difficult. I don't think it would have been possible to have a good game from this position with 3 degrees of gun depression. So 5 degrees of gun depression allows me to play it a little bit more like a medium tank and not like some kind of special, awkward medium tank. Trying to get some side shots here on the line. That's a really good thing with this tank too in this position is that basically you're shooting 1-2 or you're shooting at the hill on the 0 line. You're going to be shooting tanks in the side. So you're not going to be doing a lot of bouncing off frontal armor. Side shots with the 175 pen tend to work pretty well. You really don't need to go to the heat until you're going to a frontal attack or on really heavily armored targets. One thing I forgot to mention so far in this review that I definitely have to mention about this tank is that the tank is really good at making silver for a premium tank. I don't know what the ISU-152 is trying to do here in the middle of the map, but I'm definitely going to make him pay for it every time he comes up over the top. This tank is incredibly good at making silver. I think a lot of it has to do with ammunition costs. Basically, unlike a lot of the other mediums in the game, you're shooting a lot less shells. I don't prefer to use the heat very often just because heat rounds with a low accuracy gun like this tend to end up in tracks or just miss or go to the wrong places, so I only use heat when I know that I really need it and that it's actually going to be useful and likely to pen. I tend to shoot a lot of AP with this, and because you don't fire that often, you're not going to be shooting you're not going to be shooting 30 rounds or 40 rounds a match. And you can do a lot of damage with a lot less rounds. So, 10 pens with this tank is a huge game. And that same game would be more like 15, 16, 17 with a CDC or something like that. So this tank does make silver relatively easy, and that's a great little bonus to it. I think the silver coefficient must be pretty high too, but it's also the ammunition cost. I'm gonna end the commentary here. You can watch the videos yourself. There's not much more to say. I told you about the position I'm in. And the 5 degrees of gun depression making this tank much more versatile. So, enjoy the clips!
Target locked! We got him! Thank you. this area. Left. destroyed.
How you do it?